air with Bax and O'Brien for about 8 years now, and it seems that my Kim Kardashian impression really gets people happy and excited. And, you know, it started out with something really small, but then, you know, it's really easy to do Kim Kardashian, because all you gotta do is,
you just talk like a valley girl, like this. You're like, oh my god, the last time I was in a tight space like this was when Ray J put his spawn hammer in my stench trench and that sex tape you can purchase on YouPorn for $39.95.
But then, you know, after a while, I started feeling that I wasn't really putting enough effort into it, and then along came Caitlyn Jenner. I mean, that was just such a huge, I was so proud of her that she made that transition. And from my impression to do her, it's seemingly simple to do that, because all you gotta do is just talk out of the side of your mouth like this. It's almost like a Lorne Michaels meets Dr. Evil. You know, very simple. But then I started to think, I can't do this. I can't do the real Caitlyn Jenner without becoming Caitlyn Jenner. So that's what I started to do.
Well, I mean, the different things that he's been doing are continual. The reasoning for them, we can't figure out. He comes in here one day, he's got lipstick all over his face, or at least on his lips anyhow. It comes in the next day, looks like he's surgically had an Adam's apple removed. I'm worried he's going to rear-end somebody and kill him on the Mass Pike sometime soon.
I'm not bothered by the impression, you know, live and let live. So it's been my motto. The day that Steve came in here and asked for tampons, I thought it was probably uncomfortable.
I have a very long drive in the morning. I drive all the way from Huntington, which is about, 50 minutes away from the radio station. I do it because I just love coming to work every day. And I feel like I need to express to the listeners how important it is for them to hear about the daily Hollywood trash of what Kim Kardashian and what Caitlyn Jenner are up to. I do it for the people. I do it for them because they're the ones that matter. I come in here every day. I have a makeup artist. She puts my makeup on my face. We do a little pep talk. Hey, can you help me do my makeup? I just don't feel I'm being true to Caitlyn Jenner without having a little bit of Caitlyn Jenner inside of me. You know, the last time I had something slopped over my face was when I took Kris Jenner and I covered her in bollock yogurt.
This looks great.
I gave her some two-ball throat cream.
He redecorated the studio the other day with potted plants and throw pillows. I didn't understand it. He wanted his news music to be nothing but Broadway show tunes. It was a little confusing.
I'd ask him, what the fuck? Well, what is this? What's happening to you? What is wrong with you? Because quite frankly, I don't know that any of us is very comfortable with it. And the possibilities for the future are frightening, to say the least.
Just feel, oh, that feels so, it's a soft part of my cheek. It kind of feels like Kris Jenner squishmitten.
Do I see this as a lasting, permanent thing for Steve? Well, I think when you transition from one thing to another, like, say, the caterpillar transitions to the butterfly, it's not like the caterpillar is sitting there in the pupa and says, this ain't working out for me, I want to go back. I think once you make that leap, you've made the leap. There ain't no going back. I certainly hope that Steve knows what he's doing, because he ain't going back.
What do you think?
Beautiful. Who's a pretty girl?
I'm a pretty girl.
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 Yes, you are.
Find a star.
Well, I don't know what's going to happen, but what has to happen is it has to end. Yeah, I don't know how it ends or who's going to bring it to an end, but, you know, we've had problems enough with real females in the room, or at least the ones whose licenses said so, and was one pain in the ass after another. So, he's going to have to go.
Do I think Steve needs to go? No, I don't think Steve needs to go. We've had women on the show in the past. Steve looks just as pretty as any of the others. Maybe a little stockier, more facial hair. But, you know, with hormones and time and a whole lot of self-reflection, I'm sure Steve will be as pretty as any woman in our building.
Well, you know, many people think I should go, including John O'Brien. But I'm not going anywhere. I am going to stay here and make sure that everybody knows who Caitlyn Jenner is and why she's so important to society. Because I want the world to know that Kris Jenner once had my stomach pancakes all over her.
Steve, you're 2 minutes before news starts.
Sorry, I was shaving.